two teams yet to register a point. So that always makes for a spicier battle, doesn't it?
Absolutely. And if you look at the approaches also, and you look at the statement what the Sri Lankan captain had given just after the match, suggests that, you know, they're not really ready to be put under similar kind of condition again. And what you fear the most, usually you have to face that only. You know?
Yeah.
So that's something which so many times you've seen in cricket. So, you know,
this is what you're referring to.
Yeah, at times, you know, in the field, when you're dropping catches, you hope that, hope the ball doesn't come to me. Invariably, it comes to you and you again drop the catch. I think it's a similar kind of situation with the Sri Lankan team. They are looking for excuses outside of what is happening or outside of what is in their control, you know. What you have to do, conditions you can't really do anything about. You know, whatever has been put out there, you have to deal with that. You have to find ways and you have to put up runs on board. So today, again, batting first. What they have to focus on, rather than saying that here we go, it's tough condition, we don't want to play on these kind of conditions, we want to play on flat tracks, which we usually get in Sri Lanka, those kind of conditions they want here. But that's not going to happen. I mean, if you get those kind of conditions, it's a luxury. Yeah. But if you're not getting those conditions, you have to be prepared. You have to find ways of approaching this game and in a very positive manner. So now they have to shift from there and just look for some kind of inspiration somewhere there. Yeah. The captain himself has played a decent inning in the previous match. So, you know, he would want to continue with that, and he would look for some support from the other end.
Yeah.
If they get through this, the initial phase of that seam movement around, as I've always been saying in these conditions, get through those 20 overs. Get through those 20 overs without losing, say, two wickets. You know, if you are two down by 20 overs, it's fine. You know, you've done a decent enough job. You can build from there. Don't look at what kind of runs are there on the board. Just, you know, play that phase out. If you get loose balls, put them away. And you'll easily score at, you know, 3.5-4 runs per over. You know, so you're talking about 80 runs in 20 overs, which is not bad. And just work from there. Because on this kind of track, when the conditions are what we've seen so far, cloudy conditions, nice green tinge on the wicket, you know that 260, 270 will be enough for you to win the match.
Did you notice also the passion in his voice when he said nice green tinge?
Yeah.
He's almost wanting to take the jacket off and saying, I want to go and bowl there.
I don't think that's very true.
By the time I go there, that wicket will be dry.
But, you know, also to add to what Zach by saying, I think if it was a T20 game, there would be, you know, it'd be justified for him to say that, you know, you need good flat tracks to bat on, or, you know, but having it being a one-day game, you know, it has to have an even balance, and I don't mind it having a little bit of a tinge of grass on it, so it helps the bowlers. But like Zach Bhai said, if they can get off to a moderate start, they can bat 20 overs and lose maybe a wicket, maybe two wickets at the most, and have about 80 runs, they'll really put themselves in a great spot to kind of capitalize on the rest of the 30 overs. And wickets in hand will be a key for your team batting first on this kind of a track.
He talks about unfamiliar conditions, you know, when teams travel to Sri Lanka, very hospitable, lovely part of the world, great beaches. But if you play a test match at the SSC and you're not a spin friendly nation, you're in big trouble.
No, always. Yeah. I mean, in Sri Lanka, at times when you play, the days are going to be very long, you know.
Yeah.
Especially when you have Mahela and Sangha batting there, putting that partnership, you know, the days seem really, really long. So, yeah, but now, you know, you're in England, you know, in Cardiff, always going to be some sideways movement. People are going to look to pitch the ball up, look to get that, make advantage of that sideways movement on offer. You have to be just prepared. And you're playing your second game on this track, you know, so that should help you prepare better. You've seen it with Pakistan that, you know, the similar kind of conditions they were put in again, better attack, but they find a way of dealing with what was coming at them. They expected what kind of planning was going to be there. So far, Sri Lanka, just by seeing and hearing what the talk has been, has not given me that kind of confidence to say that, yes, they're prepared for this match.